Let us learn seafloor spreading. The formation of concept of seafloor spreading occurred after 1960. It revived the older concept of continental drift and paved the way for the modern concept of plate tectonics. Meaning of sea floor spreading. Sea is a larger saline water body surrounded by land. Now next word is floor. The exposed or outer surface on which we can travel, stand or do any activity is called floor. And next word in seafloor spreading is spreading. Spreading is the process in which there is movement of a substance from an area of high concentration to the lower concentration. It is moving out of substances from central line or point that is higher concentrations towards adjacent, that is low concentration. In this video you have seen that a drop of ink spread in a glass of water. First it was a drop, and after passing some time it has been spread entirely in the water of glass. This is an example of a spreading of color in liquid. Another example of a spreading of fire in air due to leak of gases. So this is the example of a spreading of fire in atmosphere. So initially it covers a small area, and after spreading it covers a large area. Spreading in solid material is shown here. First, paper is rolled around a stick where it stores a large length of paper. As the paper removed out from the stick, it spreads and covers larger area. Similarly, the phenomena of spreading in sea floor happens in past and continued at present. Also, thin oceanic crust is rifted by upwelling convection current of mantle. Rifting is followed by volcanic eruption. Emplacement of volcanic material in rift is continuous and spread volcanic material all along the rift axis. Again, new phase of eruption pushes older material to laterally move away from the mid of rift. Due to repetition of this spreading and emplacement of volcanic material, oceanic crust was formed. Look at this animation. Here, continuous upward movement of magma along mid-oceanic ridges produce new crust, which spreads laterally. The first form crust are spread away by another emplaced crust at the mid of ridge. This is the regular and repetitive events that form all Osaka rust. Sea floor spreading. Continental drift hypothesis was proposed by Alfred Wegener in 1912, but this theory was rejected by many objections, which also lack of any motive mechanism. Before 1910, physiographic and geological map of all continents were prepared, but no maps of ocean floor feature was available up to 1910. Therefore, continental drift hypothesis was formulated on the basis of available information of continents without any consideration of ocean. Wegener's continental drift theory was widely accepted before World War II. This theory stated that all continents of today were once joined as a single landmass. The single landmass was termed as supercontinent. The name of that supercontinent was Pangaea. As this continent were drifted through the time and attained the present location on the earth, continents are still in motion. Continents in motion plowed through the fixed and immovable sea floor. Definition of sea floor spreading. Sea floor spreading is a separation process at the middle of ocean floor in the crest of ridge through volcanic activity, and then gradually spreads away from the ridge by forming a continuous new oceanic, that is volcanic crust. So, informations about the ocean floor before World War II. It was believed that before World War II, ocean floor is flat. It is without hill, valley, and plain. It has a vast area. So, ocean floor is without any landform. It has been believed that it is almost flat and vast. New scientific information about the ocean floor. During the World War II, ocean floor were extensively mapped using recent invented equipments. Topographic map, that is hill, mountain, valley, and plain descriptions of ocean floor confirmed that ocean floor consists of flowing large features. These are mid-oceanic ridges, abyssal plain, trench, peak or hill, or sea mounts. Here we can see the hill ridge that occurs in the mid of ocean, and abyssal plain, sea mounts, and trench. In the light of recent informations during World War II and post World War II, it was confirmed that ocean floor has mid-oceanic ridges. एबेसल प्लेन, आइसोलेटेड पीक्स एंड डीप ट्रेंचेज। एबेसल प्लेन इज यूजुअली फाउंड एट डेप्थ बिटवीन 3000 मीटर एंड 6000 मीटर ऑन ओशन फ्लोर। सो दिस इज द एबेसल प्लेन दैट स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम कॉन्टिनेंटल राइज अप टू द बेस ऑफ मिड ओशनिक रिजेज। अगेन इट स्टार्ट्स हियर मिड ओशनिक रिजेज एंड अप टू द ट्रेंच। मिड ओशनिक रिजेज इट इज सिचुएटेड नियर द मिडिल ऑफ द ओशन। इट फॉर्म थ्रू ए डीप फ्रैक्चर कॉल्ड रिफ्ट वैली। इट इज द साइट ऑफ वोल्केनिक इरप्शंस एंड अर्थक्वेक एंड हाई हीट फ्लो। नेचुरली वेयर अर्थक्वेक एंड वोल्केनिक इरप्शंस टेक्स प्लेस एट द सरफेस हीट फ्लो विल बी ग्रेटर। द क्रेस्ट ऑफ मिड ओशनिक रिजेज इज फॉर्म बाय राइजिंग ऑफ मैग्मा फ्रॉम मेंटल। रिफ्ट वैली इज कंटिन्यूअसली फायर्ड एंड फिल्ड विथ वोल्केनिक लावा व्हिच टर्न इनटू बेसाल्ट दैट इज ए टाइप ऑफ रॉक थ्रू कूलिंग। दिस लीड टू मूवमेंट इन अपोजिट डायरेक्शन अपोजिट साइड ऑफ रिज क्रेस्ट। पिक्स ए सी माउंट इज सबमर्ज पीक इन द ओशन। दीज आर द आइसोलेटेड पीक दैट आर सबमर्ज इन सी। इट इज लार्ज आइसोलेटेड माउंटेन ऑन द सी फ्लोर बट इट डज नॉट रीच to the water's surface that is sea level. Sea mounts are typically formed from extinct volcanoes. Trench. Oceanic trench are topographic depression of sea floor. It is narrow in width but very long. It is the deepest part of the ocean floor. So after the topography, another new things has been happened during the World War II or post World War. Thickness of ocean crust was known through seismic refraction technique. And oceanic crust was found about 6 to 10 kilometer thick. Age of rock in ocean floor. Calculation of age of rock became possible with the use of modified potassium argon dating method. Ocean floor is covered by basaltic rock. Basaltic rock is the product of volcanic eruption. When magma upwelling up to the surface, it cools, and after cooling, basaltic rock is formed. These rocks has created uneven floor in ocean. Sediments are deposited over the ocean floor. Basaltic rock are younger in age at reach and older in age away from reach towards trench. Magnetism of ocean floor rock. It has been revealed that ocean floor is almost formed from basaltic rock. These rocks contain magnetite. Magnetite is a magnetic mineral. These minerals behave like tiny magnet. Therefore, they arrange themselves in north-south polarity of that time. Polarity of Earth is not always fixed. It changes through the geological time. On the basis of topographic informations, age of the rock, magnetic character of rocks of ocean floor, genesis of sea floor hypothesis became possible. And in this context, Hess was the first who proposed the theory of sea floor spreading in 1960. The new information about topographic, bathymetric, age and type of rock, magmatic character of rock of ocean floor that already we have discussed in previous slide has been synthesized by Hess to formulate the hypothesis sea floor spreading. Hess postulated that mid-oceanic ridges are situated over rising limb of convection current in Earth's mantle. Oceanic crust is a surface expression of mantle. Oceanic crust is simple modification of mantle. Oceanic crust is continuous created by a process of lateral accretion or spreading away from ridge. Thus, this postulation of Hess implies that ocean basins are formed by a process of spreading, rifting, and drifting a part of surrounded continents as suggested by proponent of continental drift. Hess suggested that sea floor spreading at rate of approximate 1 cm per year per flank of ridge. Hess suggested that trench system are the site of descending limb of mantle wide convection currents. He postulated that oceanic crust is thrust down into trench and largely resorbed or removed by gradually breakdown into components, material and dispersal in circulation by the mantle. After Hess, Vine and Matthew in 1963 proposed a theory according to him newly formed sea floor at the crest laterally spread away from ridge crest. These sea floor alternately normal or reverse magnetized by ambient magnetic field of that time. It laterally spread away from the crest of ridge in form of parallel bands. Alternate band of normal and reverse polarity accounts for central magnetic anomaly at crest of ridge in North Atlantic Ocean as well as linear anomalies in Northeast Pacific Ocean. The worldwide correlation and symmetry of magnetic anomaly ridge crests provide compelling evidence for seafloor spreading. Magnetic polarity. Bernard Brun has in 1906 and Motoneri Matsuyama in 1920 investigated that magnetic mineral bearing rock consists of two types of polarity, one that is normal polarity and second that is reverse polarity. Earth's magnetic field is predominantly a geoaxial dipole with north and south magnetic poles located near the geographic poles that undergo periodic reversals and excursions. Here excursions means short-lived change in field intensity with a variation in pole orientation of up to 45 degrees from the previous position. Let us understand the normal and reverse polarity. When the volcanic eruptions take place, lavas are erupted over the surface. When lava cools at 570 degrees centigrade, that is called Curie temperature, remnant magnetism appears in magnetic minerals of that lava. Magnetic minerals are arranged according to polarity, means direction of north and south of that time. Basalt is rock. Basalt formed after solidification of lava in which magnetic polarity preserved. So, basalt itself is preserving the polarity signals because basalt is composed of one of magnetic mineral, that is magnetite, and once basalt formed from lava after solidification, then the polarity, magnetic polarity may preserve in them forever. So, the polarity may be normal polarity or reverse polarity. When magnetic minerals form in present polarity is north-south, and when the magnetic minerals are arranged opposite to polarity of present time, it means the minerals are opposite to it, it means the constituent of magnetic minerals may show south directions towards the present north, then it may be said that the rock has reverse polarity. Vine and Matthews sea floor hypothesis is based on polarity. As we have discussed earlier, Vine and Matthews made assumption that newly formed sea floor at crest laterally spread away from ridge crest. These sea floor alternately normal or reverse magnetized by ambient magnetic field of that time. Sea floor spreading can be traced out with the presence of normal and reverse polarity in basaltic rock. As we know that entire ocean is covered with, made up with basaltic rock, because very first there was a rift. This is the linear fracture in the crust of that time. Volcanic eruption and formation of basalt, if erupt present time, then the polarity will be like this. Here the polarity of present time, it means north is in this direction, then all magnetic mineral will arrange with north polarity in this direction. So this polarity is termed as normal polarity. Lateral spreading of rock with normal polarity. Again, volcanic eruptions at the site of rift in reverse polarity is shown here. After the completion of normal polarity, again volcanic eruption took place along the rift, and at that time polarity was reverse and north direction, as indicated by arrow, is in this direction. So due to eruption of new magma in form of lava, earlier formed crust has been replaced from the mid laterally both side. So we can see here how these first form band of basaltic rock that possesses normal polarity shifted from their original position in this direction and in this direction, and newly formed basaltic rocks are emplaced at the mid of the crest. After passing many years, again another episode of volcanic eruption took place, and previous emplaced volcanic rocks हैज बीन लेटरली डिस्प्लेस्ड फ्रॉम दिस देयर पोजिशन इन दिस डायरेक्शन एंड इन दिस डायरेक्शन एंड एट दिस टाइम पोलरिटी इज सिमिलर टू प्रेजेंट पोलरिटी. सो दिस पोलरिटी मे बी टर्म एज नॉर्मल पोलरिटी. दस द बेंड ऑफ नॉर्मल रिवर्स नॉर्मल अगेन रिवर्स आर फाउंड ऑन द इंटायर ओशन फ्लोर. द एज ऑफ दैट बेंड हैज बीन डिटरमाइंड एंड इट हैज बीन फाउंड दैट रॉक्स नियरर टू क्रेस्ट ऑफ रिज आर यंगर इन एज एंड रॉक्स फार अवे फ्रॉम द क्रेस्ट ऑन द बोथ साइड ऑफ क्रेस्ट इज मच ओल्डर. नॉर्मल एंड रिवर्स पोलरिटी स्ट्रिप ऑन द ओशनिक क्रस्ट इटसेल्फ इंडिकेट द स्प्रेडिंग ऑफ सी फ्लोर. हियर वी कैन सी द क्रेस्ट ऑफ मिड ओशनिक रिजेज एंड अल्टरनेट बैंड ऑफ नॉर्मल एंड रिवर्स नॉर्मल रिवर्स नॉर्मल रिवर्स नॉर्मल रिवर्स पोलरिटी इन बेसाल्टिक रॉक. सिमिलर पोलरिटी इन अदर साइड ऑफ मिड ओशनिक रिजेज विथ सेम एज इज फाउंड ऑन द ओशनिक फ्लोर. सो एज ऑफ दिस रिवर्स बैंड रिवर्स पोलरिटी बैंड एंड एज ऑफ दिस रिवर्स पोलरिटी बैंड इज सिमिलर. सिमिलरली एज ऑफ दिस नॉर्मल पोलरिटी बेसाल्टिक बैंड इज सिमिलर टू एज ऑफ दिस बेसाल्टिक बैंड पोजेसिंग नॉर्मल पोलरिटी. सिमिलरली द बोथ साइड ऑफ द मिड ओशनिक रिजेज द रॉक हैव सिमिलर पोलरिटी टू दैट ऑफ अपोजिट फ्लैंक ऑफ द बेसाल्टिक रॉक. सो दीज मे बी कंक्लूडेड दैट ओशनिक फ्लोर इज स्प्रेडिंग एंड दिस हैज बीन प्रूव्ड थ्रू द अल्टरनेट अरेंजमेंट ऑफ नॉर्मल एंड रिवर्स पोलरिटी एंड एज ऑफ द रॉक. समरी ऑफ सी फ्लोर स्प्रेडिंग. मिड ओशनिक रिजेज इज फॉर्म बाय सी फ्लोर स्प्रेडिंग. New crust are formed by continuous episode of implacement of lava at rift or crest of mid-oceanic ridges. This newly formed crust spread on both lateral sides of crest of ridge. Again, earlier formed crest moved away along both flank of ridge crest by fresh eruption of lava. In this manner, sea floor spreading resulted at mid-oceanic ridge. Hess has formulated the sea floor spreading in 1960. Hess postulated that mid-oceanic ridge इज सिचुएटेड ओवर राइजिंग लिम्ब ऑफ कन्वेक्शन करेंट इन द मेंटल एंड थीन ओशनिक क्रस्ट इज कंटिन्यूअसली क्रिएटेड बाय ए प्रोसेस ऑफ स्प्रेडिंग अवे फ्रॉम रिज क्रेस्ट. थर्ड, ओशनिक क्रस्ट आर फ्रैक्चर्ड ड्यू टू रेगुलर इरप्शन एट द क्रेस्ट ऑफ ओशनिक रिजेज. द न्यूली फॉर्म्ड लावा वेजेज इंटू फ्रैक्चर. दिस इंट्रूडेड वेज पुशिंग द ओशन क्रस्ट ऑन आइदर साइड ऑफ क्रेस्ट ऑफ रिज. फोर्थ, द ओशन फ्लोर आर पुश्ड आइदर साइड ऑफ क्रेस्ट ड्यू टू वोल्केनिक इरप्शन एट द क्रेस्ट एंड डिसेंड और सिंक्स डाउन एट द ओशनिक ट्रेंचेज बाय मेंटल वाइड कन्वेक्शन करेंट एंड गेट हियर कंज्यूम्ड. दस क्रस्ट रीजेनरेट्स एट द क्रेस्ट स्प्रेड्स एंड डिस्ट्रॉयड एट ट्रेंच. हिज आर्गुमेंट अबाउट सी फ्लोर स्प्रेडिंग हैव द सिमिलरिटी विथ कन्वेयर बेल्ट सिस्टम इन व्हिच मटेरियल वंस लोडेड ओवर इट कैरीड अवे टुवार्ड्स डेस्टिनेशन इन रेपिटिव मैनर. Fine and Matthew investigated the presence of magnetic polarity anomaly in alternate band, that is normal and reverse, on both side at the equidistance and of same edge of ridge crest as evidence of spreading of sea floor. Magnetic polarity, either normal or reverse, recorded in crust. This theory is now termed as tape recorder against Hess conveyor belt theory. Thus, continents are drifted apart and together on the back of mantle wide convection current. Now, at last, look at the concept map of seafloor spreading. This is the concise mapping of all theory of seafloor spreading in one page. Simply, it can be termed as concept map of seafloor spreading. So earlier theory was continental drift. According to this theory, continents are drifting from their initial positions in geological time. But at that time, there was no reliable information about the ocean. There are some confusions about the ocean. That information is called old information, and assumptions about the ocean floor was like that ocean floor is vast, it is flat, and it has no relief. With the advancement of new equipment during the World War and after World War, new information came out about the ocean floor. Many instruments has been invented during and after World War. Some of them are PP magnetometer, KR dating method, seismic refraction methods, thermistor. PP magnetometer are used for getting the information about the geomagnetism of the rock on the ocean floor. KR dating method were used to know the age of the rock of ocean floor. Seismic refraction method or technique has been employed to know the thickness of oceanic crust. Thermistor was used to calculate the heat flow over the different region of ocean flow. All these equipment were used to understand the topography of ocean floor also, and detailed mapping of sea floor has been carried out using all those equipments that was available during the World War II and after the World War II till 1960. It was found that the ocean floor is not flat as earlier believed. Ocean floor comprises of a big or a great ridge. That ridge was called mid-oceanic ridge, and great plain that was called a vessel plain, and with some isolated hill that was called sea mount. All these are not separate from one another. All these forms a system, and another part of this system was known as trench. So trench, mid-oceanic ridges, abyssal plain, sea mounts, all are the parts of a complete system. It has been also studied that mantle is responsible for creation of new crust at the mid-oceanic ridges through its ascending convection current. After the creation of new crust on the mid-oceanic ridges, it spread laterally on both sides of the ridge and spreads in band, and these band moves towards the trench, and at trench it get consumed or it is destructed. So trench are recognized as a site of destruction of crust, and mid-oceanic ridges are known as the formation of new crust. So a chain has been recognized, mid-oceanic ridges to trench via mantle, again mantle to mid-oceanic ridges. This chain has been termed as like conveyor belt of ocean crust, and this theory states the sea floor spreading, and this theory was formulated by Hess. After the Hess, Vine and Matthew also proposed a new theory about the spreading of sea floor. according to whom volcanic eruption at the mid-oceanic ridges itself records the polarity, and as we know, polarity of Earth is changes with time. Vine and Matthew has noted that rocks at the ridge are younger in age, rocks at the trench are older in age, all the rocks are basaltic, and there are several bands having normal polarity and reverse polarity. It means all these bands once formed at the mid-oceanic ridges and spread. So Vine and Matthew also supports the sea floor spreading through magnetism recording in oceanic crust.